And today we've invited three incredible persons who is going to share some of their works and some of their thinking in this realm. We have Ulrika from the city of Malmö, we have Peter from Brick in Copenhagen, and we have Georgi from Dark Matter Labs. And usually when we do seminars, we do a Q&A at the end, but this day, today we're going to do a Q&A after each and every speaker. And that's mainly because Peter needs to go to Norway, because some of us needs to work, right? Yeah. I also want to say one very important thing. It matters who you work with. And we, you know, we are tenants at this place. And 15 years ago, dreams and wishes for creating a place that could be like a community where we could work together that eventually became known as co-working spaces. And at the time, we worked with a real estate company that was maybe a little reluctant to having like 50 or 80 companies as their clients instead of one. I mean, that's obviously much easier. But over the years, we've learned a lot from running this space. And I also think that this company has learned a lot in what it means to provide spaces for people, and also what it means to be a neighborhood. And so we're super happy to host this seminar together with Wheelboys, who runs this or owns this building and many other buildings here. And they're also the main partner of the conference, and they've been so for many, many years. And yeah, without companies like that, things, or like nonprofits like us trying to organize conferences or things, could not be possible. Another organization that is a big sponsor of and supporter of Media Evolution is the City of Malmö. And on our board sits the first speaker. And I'm very happy to invite to the stage Ulrika Forsgren Högman. And she is the, very nice title, Head of Innovation and Development at the Business and External Relations Unit, or Department, perhaps?
Department, I
at
think.
The City of Malmö. Yes. Please give a warm hand to Ulrika.
Thank you. So, hello, everyone. I'm very happy to be here to tell a little bit about an exciting initiative that we've been working on for a while, together with a group of amazing co-creators in the city. We call it the Generate District. And I think it's our take how you can construct a creative neighborhood, I think. That's our take on that, for innovation especially. So I will tell you a little bit about the process so far, about the emerging concept, and I will tell you a little bit about some insights that we got so far, and also I will broaden out a bit and talk about Malmö's business community to put the Generate District into its context, local context especially. So, first, we started off, as many do today, in the urgent need to address the challenges we're meeting today, we need to tackle in the future and today. So, but our belief is that there's so many ideas out there already. We have the knowledge, we have the ideas, but we rather lack the structures and the system to properly collect them and maybe implement them. So that's our focus. We also believe that the shape and the surroundings and the space deeply affect people, how they react and act, and the capacity of creativity and innovation. So, the mission for Generate District is to create a context and a spatial experience that encourage transformative actions that are bold, that are non-traditional, and that really can help changing the world, and in many perspectives, socially, economically, environmentally, in any way. So it's a very broad perspective on that. And at the same time, succeeding in attracting a wide range of people, that's not only the usual suspects. And that in itself is a very challenging task, I think. I think many of you know that, is to get not the usual suspects around the table. So, what do we do? we know the closeness is, especially to other creators, is really important. And even more especially when you work with knowledge intense endeavors. So there's science that tells us that just over 750 meters, the benefits of closeness disappears completely. I mean, it's really disappeared completely, 750 meters. So proximity, closeness is really important for innovation and creativity. And of course, we all know that it's when people meet that the magic happens. So it's important. We're also thinking of aiming, the Gent District is aiming to provide a third place for community-driven third place, open on and off working hours, that being a place that people can socialize, learn together, do business together, and in informal ways, as you do in third places. And hence, to succeed in this, we need to create an innovative zone that really find a way to creatively utilize the space and the surroundings. And this is a challenge. A fun challenge, though. So, basically, this is the district that we're looking at. That's not fixed boundaries, but it's more or less the place we're picturing in front of us. Here you find a critical mass of really interesting companies. 150 companies that are key players in a process like this. We have mapped them up. And you can find a dense collection of... you have large corporations, consulting agencies, you have educators, innovative suppliers, innovation suppliers, product developers and so forth. So it's a lot of interesting stakeholders in this area. And as you can see, we have spotted them some. Of course, Malmö University with their 5 research areas, really important, 25,000 students. We have Varvstaden, just the neighbor here. Oatly's home for Oatly's head office, and soon to become the place for and a home for the faculties of artistic faculties of Lund University, and therefore also Malmö's art campus. We have Medievolution that you talked about, Martin, this great place here, and we have Mink, Malmö incubator, just over there. There has been a successful startup scene for over 20 years. And of course, Nyhamnen, this large, big area that we also work a lot with in my unit, that is the largest urban development project in the city for a long time. It's going to go for a long time. It's a huge process going on there. And they have high ambitions, and we have high ambition when it comes to sustainable solutions and to tackle the climate challenges. So this is a really exciting area. And I just want to point out, of course, this is just a district. We talk about closeness. This is open for everybody. So, and Malmö is a small city. So it's not that this is an area that is like have boundaries to the world, just to fix a place. I said that we'll broaden out a bit and talk about Malmö as a business community and what characterizes whatever. What's a typical Malmö business city? Yeah. Well, we have close to 40,000 companies in Malmö, more exact 39,200, I think. And here there's a lot of keen up-and-commerce companies. We have small entrepreneurs. We have strong brands in a really, really exciting mix in the city. The city has a long history of brave decisions when it comes to sustainability, transformation, and urban development. The business sector in Malmö grows faster than any other major cities in Sweden. Since the turn of millennium, we have growth 62% in the business sector. So it's really fast growing. And of course, a large portion of international talent. We have a lot. We have 186 nationalities in Malmö, which gives us a huge bank of talent, international talent. We have categorized the companies in Malmö in 14 new different industries that we find interesting because it's better mirroring how the business and industries looks today. And we have identified 14 new industries. As you can see, design, communication, and creative content is the biggest industry in Malmö when it comes to number of companies. And I've been presenting this for a while now, and a lot of people got amazed. They didn't know that. This is new information, sort of. So, followed by service design, analysis, and data. So if you still look at the number of employees, the strongest industries in Malmö is tech companies, restaurants, and healthcare. We have also categorized and looked closer to the kind of work that's going on in companies. So industry, one thing, what actually is happening, how do they work in the companies is another perspective. And because that's important when you develop a city, what type of work are the companies doing? So the largest business types, when it comes to business type in Sweden, in Malmö, it's services followed by production and manufacture. Yes. So we usually say that Malmö as a business city is vibrant, it's in constant growth, and it's diverse, creative, and the feeling is really down to earth. And diverse in the sense that there's so many companies here, like I said, 39,000 companies, and 92% of them has less than 9 employees. Less than 9 employees. I mean, 37,000. So, and just about 560 companies in Malmö has more than 50 employees. So that gives us some picture when we work with development. There's a lot of power in these small companies. And creative in the way that we attract a lot of creative companies, a lot of creative people, and they really invest in good ideas and in innovation, and the conference is just one beautiful example of that. And the speed is down to earth. I mean, Malmö is very famous for having low barriers. It's easy to join communities. We're open to others. Sharing is caring. I mean, I've been running company here for 15 years. That's the feeling we have towards each other. So, back to general district. As we started off the process with, okay, why do we exist? What is the big reason to exist? What is our why? And we formulated that we, General District, wants to create a context that radically redo, rethink, and reimagine. And the guiding star for that is fair growth and multi-perspective transformation. That's what we want to accomplish and have this like a guiding lines for here, the whole district, the work in the district. Some insights along the way that we've really been thinking about, and we see as very important to have bear in mind all the time, is the importance to create a context where opportunities and knowledge are made accessible and easy to translate into the companies. Because if you have so many small companies, and that's a transition that's happening everywhere, it's really difficult to get the time, effort to transform things into your business. You have to have muscles and resources to be managed to do that. So we think that's really important. Can we build a context that really enables that in some way? We don't know why. We are very creative here. We don't know how yet, but we're going to work with that. And but like I said before, it's not the lack of knowledge in many ways. We always need knowledge, of course, but we have a lot of knowledge. And we have a lot of universities here, but we don't have the structures to implement them. It's also very important that this type of districts is following and are aligned to the DNA of the city. We're looking a lot of that on that too. And of course, branding. Branding is very important. This is a quick sketch how we like illustrate the framework for the work at the moment. Sharing economy is a guiding star for us also. We're looking at ways to build new business models to be created in that sense. Innovation zone, like I said before, how can we create a surrounding that really wakes the creativity and the boldness that we need. Third place, I told you before, and TCC infrastructure, we're working with this, the idea of connecting communication, creativity, and community. And in that structure, a framework, we're also working with we need an organization, a structure, and we want, like I said, innovative business models. We're thinking about multi-stakeholders governance, how that can look like. Dedicated professional management is really important, and mixed financing. We need to have all type of capital, and we know that public funding is really difficult in many cases. They are short of money these days. And finally, a site. We are pitching a site, like hosting something, lab, hosting, knowledge sharing. We are looking at some of sort of a subscription system for shared facilities, for open spaces and knowledge. But this is just in the beginning. And the aim is also to create a type of marketplace for ideas and investments. So, what's up now? We're just in the beginning of a process. This is a very innovative, iterative process. We have just got fundings from Tillväxtverket, and so we're starting up and deepening the processes this autumn. And we have three perspectives on that one. One is explore and strengthening the district's offer and concept. The other one is looking deeper into the financing and organizational perspective on the process. And the third is to intensify the work with the branding. And hopefully, in the beginning of next year, we have a site that we can start launching Gender District in the next level. Thank you for listening.